Susan, Ismail. One, two, three.
Next, please.
Pwede ho mag-smile kayo?
Smile!
Thank you!
Have a good time, guys!
Sa
pandaan dito.
Down the road to find out how much it is worth. The young lady did. And she came back to her father and said, They said they could give me $1,000 because it's old. Then the father said, take it to the pawn shop in town and see how much they could give you. She came back and said, Dad, they're willing to give me just $100 because it's old. The father shrugged and told his daughter, drive to that exclusive car club in the middle of town and find out what they say. The obedient child went and came back. Father, they are offering $100,000 for the car. They told me it's an iconic Nissan Skyline R34. So the father said, we learn our lessons. Know your worth. If you find yourself in a place where you are not valued, stay away and find the right place where you are valued and respected. Friends, I like to think that our members in FALSA have grown and members have stayed because they are valued and respected here in our midst. Seniors find our purpose in our association. So today, we are celebrating the 126th Independence Day of the Philippines. The event draws images, cherished memories that fit deep into our core as Filipinos. We are especially delighted that today we have this engineer Leo Ortega and his wife. Engineer Leo is our guest speaker. Let's give him a hand. And we are so delighted that we have our very own City of Chino Hills Mayor, Cynthia Morales. And the senior representative from the 4th District of San Bernardino County, Suzette Dang. We have families here, the family of our 2024 Lorceli Tulao is over there. My family is over here and over there. My children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren.
Yes.
And so many of our families and friends are here. It's a happy sight indeed. Today's program was planned and prepared by a driven group of 5 members who have gone through a rewarding, they claim, experience of camaraderie and collaboration. So here we are, giddy and waiting for me to stop so we could get on with it. So let's have it. Digna, Master of Ceremony. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dana Hickerson. I'll be your host today and a facilitator of our program, Kalayaan 2024. We have prepared a very special program for your entertainment, providing knowledge of our Filipino culture that includes music, food, dance. We hope you will enjoy yourselves with what we have prepared. Okay, and we will start the program. Calling on Soren. Thank you.
designed Filipino-American Dance Company, founded in 2023, is a Southern California-based dance company that aims to showcase Filipino culture and history in its purest form through song and dance. Today, we present to you the stories that abound throughout the entire archipelago of islands. Ladies and gentlemen, the Dalisay Filipino-American Dance Company.
Thank you.
As you know, pasta has started a quarter, so as we gather in this small place, we will be singing. Who here has family members that were very instrumental to at least the 40s and 50s for a while?
Just told me we're going to there for lunch.
Thank you. was diskalayaan in yesteryears, but they're still pretty. Miss Conchita Stower. She will present the banner. Next, we have Miss Aurora. Aurora Ortega. Laila Flores for the scepter. And our Miss Kalayaan, oh wait, but she was the Miss Kalayaan, present the crown. Miss Helen Rock. And now we're going to welcome our Miss Kalayaan 2024, Miss Lori Tulao, escorted by her grandson, Nicholas Ryan. Please give her a hand. Lori herself was a captain of the Philippine Army as a nurse. She married Felicito Tulao, who served 20 years in U.S. Army. They have three girls, Frances, the eldest. She's a retired major in the U.S. Air Force. Her two other daughters, Jessica and Ariane, are both married to men in peacekeeping force. Miss Adrienne. Lori worked as an ER nurse for 37 years. She was awarded the Philippine Heritage, one of the best and outstanding nurses. Please welcome Miss Lori Tulao. And we are going to get the award, the sash from Miss Conchita. Give her a hand. And picture, please. Ikaw, Aurora. And the bouquet by Miss Aurora. Please give her a hand. And Miss Laila Flores, handing the scepter. Please give a hand. And Miss Helen to crown the queen. Thank you. hear some words from Lori.
Cynthia Morin, Judith Tang, distinguished guest Leo Ortega, my beloved council members, board members, president, and the great five Mutyana Palayaan, and council members, officers, my family Pasa, and guests, my family, my own family. I'm deeply honored to have been crowned Mutyana Kasarinlan or Kalayaan. I take pride in anything and everything that pertains to the mother country, the Philippines, and our country, United States of America. Serving this country runs in my blood. I served as a military nurse for 2 years in the Philippine Army when our family migrated to the USA. I worked as the registered nurse for 37 years. I was recognized as an outstanding nurse by the Philippine International Heritage. My late husband, Felicito, served and retired 20 years in the Navy. My oldest daughter, Frances, is a retired major in the U.S. Air Force. Wow. And my two daughters, Adrian and Jessica, both married to a law enforcement officers. Today, I'm being escorted by my grandson, who is a chief officer, Brian Tulao, who has been actively enlisted for 10 years. Wow. An officer this July 1st. You can see how much I love my family and I have for my country. It is with PASA that I have found a new family of dedicated and committed members. My goals are to keep family traditions, values, and community ties bonded and firmly rooted in respect, integrity, and faith in God.
Amen.
This is one of the great honor of my life. I, Lord Sally Tulao, proudly stand as Mutyana Kalayaan for 2024. I thank you.
And now, with no further ado, we're going to hear a tribute to her mother by Major Frances. Yeah.
dito. Mm-hmm. Hindi kaya ko dito. No, mas matapang.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for being here. We also have my mom, my nieces and nephews here too. And then we'll just wanted to say there's our table of family right there. So they're here to support her, support Asa. Appreciate it. All right. So, just made it. Good afternoon, everyone. And welcome to the coronation of our mom, Lorcelli Talao. She is Miss, I'm gonna mess it up, guys. Muchanan Kalayan. 2024. I have an accent. Welcome and thank you, President Mjita, Vice President Adelina, Mayor Cynthia Moran, and also I have your name, Suzette. Suzette. Yes, Miss Suzette Day. I appreciate you all being here for us. So, this title totally fits our mom perfectly. Because Muchanan Kalayan in English means Jewel of Freedom. And like a gem, our mom has so many facets. I only have time to say four of them. Number one, her presence. She's a strong social butterfly. And I say strong because social butterflies are, you know, you ever thought of flighty, because I'm a social butterfly, but she's a social butterfly with meaning. So if you have a question or anything and want a serious answer, she will happily find the answer for you or answer it for you. Also, she enjoys the dancing and planning birthday lunches for her friends and family. Number two, her smile.
Yeah.
When she smiles, those dimples stand out, right? That's the first thing you see, and then you just can't help but approach her and start talking to her. So many dimples. Her family, again, her family's here, we're all here to support my mom. In the morning, she would talk to her sisters every day. And they talk all morning. Now, she just loves them. She and my dad also raised three daughters. She showed us how to work hard, be independent, and enjoy life. We, in turn, are raising our kids to be the same. And she is a great-grandmother to four great-grands, and Vanessa just had our fourth. Number four, her FASA family. She wakes me up every other Monday to come here. And you know, first it was forced, but now I wake up just to get ready to be here. This group of family is so much fun. Lots of laughing, lots of dancing. So she enjoys being a member of this group. She loves the Filipino spirit of her brothers and sisters. And again, lastly, I think she's here because of the music and the dancing. Exhibit number one. All right, so this gem of a lady represents independence and the spirit of the Philippines. Thank you, FASA, for unanimously voting her with this honorary title. We love you all.
Now we're going to have Bert Legaspi to serenade Miss Kalayan. Yes. Give me a hand, please. You really work hard for this.
Narudo ba ako mantay? Wala si Rory.
Can I say something first? It is indeed a great pleasure being asked to sing to our reigning Muchanang Kalayaan and to all of you. I'm just used to singing to my wife when she's upset. So this might be, I would say, the highlight of my senior year, singing to all of you, or it might turn out to be the worst day of my life. Hit it, DJ.
Nice bird.
104.
Mrs. Conchita Steer, PASA President, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. I'd like to share something funny. Kakakain nyo lang po eh. Para magising ng konti. I heard about this 85-year-old man. He was fishing one morning. He heard a voice, "Pick me up." He looked around, didn't see anybody, and thought he was dreaming. He heard it again, "Pick me up." He looked down and saw a frog. He said, "Are you talking to me?" The frog said, "Yes, pick me up and kiss me, and I'll turn into your beautiful bride." The man quickly picked up the frog and put it in his front pocket. The frog said, "Wait a minute. I said, kiss me, and I'll turn into a beautiful bride." The man said, "No thanks. At my age, I would rather have a talking frog." In my case, I kissed my frog some 55 years ago, and there she is, still my beautiful bride. Now, I'm here to talk about the Philippines gaining independence from the United States, but I figure that We all needed a little bit of Philippine History 101. So here goes. The Philippines, also known as Republic of the Philippines, is the second largest archipelago in the world. The Philippine archipelago comprises about 7,641 islands during low tide. In high tide, it's about 7,100. And they are clustered into three major groups: Luzon, the Visayas, and Mindanao. The national flower of the Philippines is the Sampaguita, also known as Philippine jasmine or Arabian jasmine. The national tree is Nara. The Philippines is also known as the Pearl of the Orient for its richness in culture and beauty of its landscape. This title, Pearl of the Orient, was popularized by the Filipino national hero, Dr. Jose Rizal, in his poem, Mi Ultimo Adios, My Last Farewell, before he died in 1896. His writing and activism inspired the Philippine people to fight for independence. Filipinos are considered Asian because the Philippines is officially listed as a Southeast Asian country by the United Nations. So we are not Pacific Islanders. Next time that you put the checklist, ethnicity or ethnic group, it is Asian. Filipinos are known for their hospitality, respect for elders, their religion, and humor. In 1521, a Portuguese explorer named Ferdinand Magellan discovered the Philippines, and it was claimed by Spain. Ferdinand Magellan was killed in the Battle of Mactan in Cebu. The Philippines was named after King Philip II of Spain by a Spanish explorer named Roy Lopez de Villalobos. The Philippines was first colonized by Spain in 1565 and for the next 333 years. The country was under Spanish rule, although the Spanish rulers did not generally mix with the local populace. The Spanish language, religion, and custom were imposed on the Filipinos. During this time, the Filipinos fought for their rights and freedom, but was continually met with suppression and violence. Historians suggest that the roots of the Philippine Revolution began with the building of the Suez Canal in 1869. With access to Europe, the Filipinos were exposed to new ideas about freedom and returning home questioning the Spanish rule. The Philippines was fully underdeveloped after a 333-year period of Spanish rule, no roads or any infrastructure. Government corruption was traditional. Many areas was ruled by the Catholic Church, and every bit as corrupt, perhaps even more than the government. Even the Pope tried to crack down on the Philippine Catholic Church and was ignored. The Philippines was a Spanish colony when the Spanish-American War broke out in 1898. The outbreak of the Spanish War was brought Commodore George Dewey and the U.S. Asiatic Squadron to Manila Bay. Meantime, the Philippine Revolution, led by General Emilio Aguinaldo, who established a revolutionary government at the height of its military successes against Spain, the revolutionary government proclaimed independence on June 12, 1898. Aguinaldo became president of the Philippine Republic. During the Spanish-American War, the United States defeated Spain, and as part of the Treaty of Paris, signed in December of 1898, that ended the war, Spain gave the Philippines to the United States, and also Spain sold the entire Philippine archipelago to the United States for 20 million. The Filipinos who had been fighting for independence from Spain now found themselves in conflict with the United States, which had different plans for the Philippines. The Philippine-American War happened lasting from 1899 to 1902. Although the Filipinos put up a strong resistance, they were eventually defeated by the more equipped and numerous American forces. Following the end of the American War, the United States established a colonial rule over the Philippines for 48 years. Over the next few decades, the United States implemented various reforms and infrastructure projects in the Philippines, but the ultimate goal remained independence. In 1934, the United States Congress passed the Tidings-McDapia, which provided for the establishment of the Commonwealth of the Philippines as a transitional government with the promise of full independence within 10 years. The Philippines became a self-governing commonwealth with Manuel L. Quezon as its first president. The Philippines was set to become fully independent after a 10-year transitional period. However, the outbreak of World War II delayed the process. For 3 years, the Philippines was in the hands of the Japanese. Most Filipinos supported the guerrilla resistance movement. The guerrillas remained loyal to the Philippine Commonwealth and the United States. General Douglas MacArthur, famous for the words, "I shall return," did return and landed in Leyte in October of 1944, thus commencing the military campaign to liberate the Philippines from the Japanese. The Philippine government returned with General MacArthur, and as the Battle of Manila ended, the government was restored in Malacañang Palace in Manila. After 333 years of Spanish rule, 3 years of Japanese occupation, and 48 years of American colonization, the Philippines finally gained its independence from the United States on July 4, 1946, and the country became a sovereign nation. This is a simplified overview of how the Philippines gained from the United States, independence from the United States. The journey to independence was marked by both cooperation and conflict between two nations, as well as a significant political and social developments within the Philippines. The July 4 Independence Day of the Philippines coincided with the independence of the United States, resulting in some confusion in the Philippines and abroad. July 4, 1946 Independence Day also marked the 500th year of Magellan's arrival and the bringing of Christianity to the Philippines. However, on May 12, 1964, due to political reasons, the then President, Diosdado Macapagal, moved the celebration to June 12 in order to commemorate General Emilio Aguinaldo's original proclamation of Philippine independence from Spain, which was June 12, 1898. July 4 became as the Filipino-American Friendship Day. On a final note, I would like to leave you with a question. Do you think that the Philippines would be better today if it had remained as a Commonwealth of the United States? Yes. Think about that. Yes. Yes. There's no right or wrong answer. It's just food for thought. Thank you for listening. You have been a great audience. It's an honor and a privilege to stand before you. I thank you. Mabuhay ang Pilipinas.
Now we would like to call on Mayor Chris Sitya.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
It's an honor to stand before you as your mayor of Chino Hills today as we commemorate the 126th Philippine Independence Celebration hosted by the Filipino American Seniors Association. I want to first extend my thanks to FASA for organizing this celebration and having me as your guest. My colleagues on the City Council and I are so proud to have such a vibrant and dedicated organization such as FASA here in our state. For over 30 years, FASA has showed an unwavering commitment to preserving and celebrating the Filipino culture. Chino Hills is a city enriched by its diversity, with over 40% of our population comprising of Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders. This diversity is one of our city's greatest strengths, bringing together people of different backgrounds, faiths, and cultures, creating a community where everyone feels welcome and celebrated. Organizations like FASA play a crucial role in keeping these cultures alive, offering a space for individuals to connect, share, and celebrate their heritage. Today, we not only celebrate the rich history and culture of the Philippines, but also the vibrant diversity that makes Chino Hills such a wonderful place to live. At this time, it is my pleasure to award a certificate of recognition to the 2023 and 2024 FASA leadership team, and I'd like to invite FASA President Conchita Sturr to accept the certificate on behalf of your outstanding team. This is for the FASA 126th Independence Day Celebration Project Team. There's one for every member of your great team, Conchita. It was a pleasure working with you before this happened today. And this is not really part of my script, but you guys are on the board too, but I just wanted to let you know that it's my pleasure every year. I select a few nonprofit organizations to receive some charitable funds on my behalf. And so this year I'd like to present a $1,000 donation to your club. Humble and welcoming group. It's a pleasure to have you here so long in Chino Hills, and we appreciate you. So this recognition is a testament to your energized goal of strengthening community ties and fostering a spirit of unity and collaboration within Chino Hills. Next, I'm proud to present a certificate to Soren Jarabello, did I say that right? The choreographer and director of the Dali City Filipino American Dance Company. If you could please join me. They did such a wonderful job today. Yes. Great job, thank you so much. And Soren, your dedication to revitalizing Filipino culture through the performing arts is very commendable, and your work not only preserves your heritage, but also brings joy to our community. I just wanna thank you again for all being here, your contributions, and for making Chino Hills a city that is proud to celebrate our diversity, our city. We thrive from the contributions from our residents, and events like these just remind us of the strength that is in the unity of all these cultures. So, salamat po. Thank you, it's always a pleasure. I'm humbled to be here, thank you.
Thank you very much, Mayor Moran. And we have our big five, the ladies who planned and worked on preparing this program. I'll read your names and then maybe later on we can have a group picture. Is that okay? And we have Percy Salta. If you would stand where you are so you can be recognized. Edina. Nina Sabino. Wants to give a certificate for
Laura Sally Tulao. If I could have her come up. The 2024 Kalayaan. Kalayaan.
Let's say Mabuhay three times. Mabuhay!
Congratulations. Mr. Leo have advised me earlier that in English, when you translate it correctly, it means muse. Muse of Miss Freedom. Yes? Okay. So congratulations, 2024. I'm going to mess it up, but how do you say it again? Mutaya Ngani. Mutaya Kalaya. Congratulations. Okay, and on behalf of Supervisor Kurt Hagman, we would like to recognize the FAFSA 126th Independence Day Celebration Project Team. There are several one of you, so I'm going to call one at a time. Percy Salka. Come on up. Beginya. Gina. Beginya. Namia Sabino. Virgie Kabagna. And Miss Digna Nickerson, of course. And Mr. Soren Jarabello. Did I say it correctly? Come on up. So for this one, who are your girlfriend, director of the Lisay Filipino American Dance Company? In honor of your excellent work in revitalizing Filipino culture through the performing arts. So this is Ms. Doran, you're from Supervisor Hagman.
Thank you.
Poor boy.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Muna tayo ng letrado.
Okay, let's continue the last of the raffles. Before we end the program, we're going to have a big surprise, a big dance from the group. So let's do the Miss Nora.
Okay, nito mayo. Yes.
Okay.
998. Winner? Winner 998. 998. Okay. We have a red ticket. 346. Red ticket. 346. Winner!
Rico Puno.
Zero eight eight. Yay. Okay. 013. Oh, we have a winner back there for 013. Here she comes. 115. 115. Oh, we have a winner. Okay, the next ticket is 036. 036. Winner! Okay, next one is 030. 030. Oh, winner right there, 030. And the last one of today, good luck everybody, 040. 040. 040.